Oh, I got a stitch. Oh, Jesus. Oh, see you in a bit.
Should I say bonjour?
Damn.
Pat's game is gone.
Go to Italy. They have petrol.
See that? It is cold.
Kind of lost my bearings a little bit, but I believe I'm heading out that way.
Oh my word. I am going to need my torch.
Did a quick bacon around the corner.
Looking at this shit.
Well, it's been a mad morning already. The first place I went to didn't work out, and as I was going down the road, having trouble with the clamp that I was using for my clutch, and started slipping. I couldn't pull away, and this guy just came out of nowhere and he asked me if I needed help, if my motor was broken. And I was like, yeah, and we took it around the corner to a guy that he knew, and he couldn't do anything. So then we loaded the bike into the back of his work van. There's probably fuel all over the inside of it, and he drove me to this place, and it's currently out the back being worked on. Oh, I felt like crying when we were putting the bike in the back of his van. So helpful. I don't know what I would have done, but didn't have to think about that. Yay!
Clutch cable, yeah, the beast all loaded back up, and just hop up on this, whoa, with this precipitous drop on the other side. That's nice down there, not so nice, but it did serve me well. I got my bike fixed and I'm back on the road.
So now we are making our way back up the hill to the last bit of the Trans-Euro trail in France, and the next time I talk to you will probably be at the old border crossing into Italy.
Unfortunately, I broke my Chinese clamp that my GoPro is attached to. So I'm going to put you on my helmet. forgot I had my washing drying on the back of my bike when I was riding through Nice earlier.
Last bit of France. Boys and girls, that over there is France, and that over there is Italy. There's a set of more useless signs than this.
I don't want to see them.
It's been like this and worse for
about 5Ks.
I say worse. Depends on your point of view. I'm quite enjoying it. I'm quite tired.
The view's a good day. So there's quite a few of these places on this route, and this bit has been turned into like a body type thing. Oh, someone's left a bike here. She looks right at home here with a Mad Max face. Morning peeps. So, woken up in this beautiful spot. Incredible little campsite. I can thoroughly recommend it. I won't try and pronounce it because I will butcher it. But
It's that place.
Absolutely incredible. And it's right on the trail as well, so perfect. Not a bad start to a Friday morning. There you go. I haven't researched this route whatsoever. Just decided I was going to Italy. So yeah, I don't know what's coming up. We shall see. So I mislaid a sock and I've just found it. Because I could smell burning. And yeah, I don't think I'll be wearing that one again. Bollocks. Insane is this. So cool. Just waiting for the DJI app to download so I can get the new drone out, but I'm now wondering with all these crows about if that's a good idea. I guess we'll find out in a bit.
Passe de Panarel. 2,045 meters. Boom. I don't know who's got the right of way here.
Hope that worked. Pinch myself a few times along this trail. I guess I must be awake. Seriously, like, how is this possible? hopefully found my spot for the night. Beautiful noise. Right there. Underneath that tree. So, that was a pretty epic day. Woke up at that beautiful campsite. Yeah, last night, after the whole getting a new clutch cable and everything, got myself into a little bit of a tiz yesterday evening. I was riding up and up and up and up and it just wasn't stopping. I was getting, the cloud was getting thicker and thicker and it was getting colder and colder. So I turned around, went back down the hill and stopped at that, they call it Agro Turismo. It's like a campsite, and then they got a yurt there, and they got a couple of like permanent old caravans and stuff. Yeah, really cool. There's a beautiful little spot, solar shower block. It's all super basic, but I mean, if that's all you need. Left there at about 9:30 in the end. So like 3 hours earlier than the last 2 days. Ended up going through a national park, which I wasn't prepared for. Keep cash on you at all times. I didn't have any. And I almost didn't get through the national park because the guy at my end didn't have a credit card machine. So he phoned up the guy at the other end and he was like, yeah, ours is working. He can pay when he gets here. So that was pretty spectacular. And then just outside, just on the other side of the trail, I can't remember the name of the village, but like up above it, it's because it's like a ski town. Stopped and had a beer, a heated sandwich and some apple strudel. So it was a good day. And then there's been about another 30 km to this point. It is 5:30. I think sunset is 7:30. So I'm just gonna chill out for a bit before I unpack the bike and put the tent up and stuff, because nothing worse than getting the tent up and then somebody coming along and moving me on. So that is pretty much that for the day, I think. If nothing else interesting happens, I will catch you in the mañana. See you later. Don't know what the rules are about making coffee on the side of the road. So, you can't actually see anything at all. But something did happen yesterday evening. I had to move on. And I'm in a field now. So I'm packing up and shifting on before anybody turns up. I should explain more in a bit. It's now about 7:20. I'm all packed up. That's where I was. And there's loads of fresh digging around and poo. So yeah, surrounded by pigs and deer all night. Onward. Absolutely stunning through here this morning. Bloody cold.
but stunning. Look at it.
Just beautiful. Can't wait for that sun to come up. Find somewhere nice to have a coffee. Just incredible this morning. There she goes. So, yes, it is Saturday, I'm going to say the 8th, don't know. So yeah, last night I had that beautiful spot up on top of the hill, surrounded by cows and everything, and sat there minding my own business. I thought I was tucked far enough back that you couldn't see me from the little trail bit at the bottom. Apparently not. Couple of 4x4s came up, and then these farmer looking dudes got out and they looked directly up the hill at me, almost as if they knew I was there. So I don't know if they heard the bike or something, and then were like, hang on a minute, that's stopped in the middle of nowhere, let's go and check it out. Because there was evidence of there was like a little park area with some benches, and there was evidence of fires, so I presume maybe the local kids or whatever, I don't know, they have an issue with it, so they went up to investigate. So rather than get told to move on, I just decided to go before it got too dark, and then it did start getting dark, and then I found myself in the corner of a field on the edge of a wood, surrounded by strange noises. So yeah, once I got my head round the idea that those noises, if they are not accompanied by a torch, then they will be an animal, and most of the animals here are fine. Pigs can get a bit aggressive, but I don't think they would if I was just laying there, and plus there's a shitload of food about. There's tons of chestnuts and beech nuts and God knows whatever food there is. So but I did Google the other day, I don't know why, does Italy have bears and wolves? So I think that was maybe playing on my mind a little bit to begin with, but it took me about half an hour just messaging my folks and stuff to let them know I was okay and things like that, and joking around about ghosts and ghouls and Slender Man and stuff. And excuse the traffic, it's very busy this morning. Yeah, and yeah, it was fine. I got a pretty good night's sleep actually. And then this morning my alarm went off at 10 to 7, opened up the tent door, scared off a few deer, and got packed up, and I was away by 20 past or something. I don't know what the time is now, but it's probably, I don't know, 8:45 maybe. So yeah, just gonna have my coffee on the side of the road because it was too cold to do it anywhere else. And this view, as you've hopefully seen, is absolutely incredible. Yeah, and then just keep plodding on. Keep on plodding on. Not gonna get anywhere near the lakes, let alone the Dolomites. Trail going is slow, but I don't mind, it's awesome. And this beast, not only is she only 125 and laden down with a few extra kilos of gear and myself, but she's also not very well. I think it's just a fueling issue, because I had another exhaust on there, so I think the ECU's gone a bit, I don't know what I'm doing. Get her home. But yeah, I've got another week, so yeah, I'm gonna try and do the Col de Papelion, I think it is, and then that links kind of into the Col de Bonnet. So I'm gonna take that route home, I think, because they look pretty awesome. And yeah. That's that for now.
Sit rep, I'm wet and my hands are cold, and it stopped raining now, well, kind of. The higher I'm getting, it seems to be better, and the further away from where I was. She was getting loads of water up into the electric, so was misfiring quite a lot, but then we just pulled over into a petrol station and the heat of the engine dried everything out. So I'm quite impressed, really, because it has been pissing down. Yeah, we're doing all right. So yeah, should be okay. And it looks like it's even brightening up. Nice warm hotel room with a very hot shower.